I began to do some drawings of girls coming out of a couch, not coming out of a couch, tied up, wrapped. They were wrapped in, I bought big pieces of satin, taffeta. Great, I go to John Lewis, I buy these materials, great strips of taffeta, and tied up Lila in various positions so that she's trying to break out of this bound, being bound, hands and so on. It's not to do with prison or anything like that. It's to do with a psychological state of mind. And then I did a whole series of them. And afterwards I thought, well, I must do bigger, much bigger than this. And I will do just drawings, just black and white, and I'll try and get better at drawing, get better at it by copying it as clearly as I can and as strictly as I can, no matter what is in front of me, no matter what. So then I constructed the figures made out of Lila, actually got a skeleton, a woman's skeleton, which she then covered in cotton and silk stockings on top. And she made the skeleton woman. I made the head, which is all crumbling, so it's like a death's head, really. And we had various creatures. And because I thought, well, I thought about the Muses, because the Muses, before they were Muses, were followers of Dionysus, and they were the Maenads. Maenads can destroy, and the Muses protect. They protected Orpheus, but he was destroyed by the Maenads in the end. And I'm very interested in Jane Harrison's book, the I can't say the word, but the Introduction to Greek Religion. It's going to go another one. And I read that a lot before, because I did lots of pictures when I was much younger, collages on Gorgons, the Harpies, all those creatures, Greek violence and disruption. And I was very, very interested in that. And I thought that certainly the Muses as Maenads could be very interesting, because they represent a state of mind, and because of the damage they can cause, and particularly to themselves. And so I started doing a series of Muses, you see, and I'm using these creatures and just putting flowers on their head and baby poets on the ground. There's one of Tony as a baby poet in a cot with the Muses around, and my little granddaughter pulling the lemons apart. And so I started doing this all, and then it turned, and then the subject matter developed into other things. But the drawings went on the same, because, you know, the fact that I was standing there doing these drawings, and, you know, just pencil, graphite, and Conte pencil I used. I have so much completely in graphite, and which more difficult to see because they reflect the light. So I thought I must get some Conte pencils, but in fact it's different but not so subtle, right? But you can see them better. And I started to, and I just started faithfully setting up a scene, trying to draw it as carefully as I could. That's what they are, exercises, really, exercises in drawing. But of course, you have to have a story in order to do something, otherwise you're bored stiff. If you just have a figure there, you've got to have a story. So I did the story, you know, this like, you know, that Zubaha thing, and then I made a tree that's a muse, and the tree has roots that squash the babies. And then there's this rather plump lady who looks after my house, and she came and dressed up as another muse. And behind her is hanging her husband, who hung himself, but he's also a muse. So there was a forest of muses, right? and a little girl turned up, so I put her in the picture as well, and just did the thing as I went on like this. And then that one is more difficult. That's got willies in it, you know, got willies in it.
On the floor?
Hmm?
On the ground?
On the ground, she's carrying one, do you see the one behind with it round her neck? That's like the lacoon, but it's not a lacoon, it's not a snake, it's something else, I know. And they're all really like, well, anyway, so the back eye as well, like the back eye. So that's it really. It's drawing, it's about drawing.